Hi guys, excuse me. I'm recording this with a cold, so if I sound a little funny, I'm sorry. So today we're doing our presentation on Zoophilia and Beastiality. My name's Tina Shirley, and my partner was Marshall Hicks. So first, we're gonna go over the definitions of Zoophilia and Beastiality. So Zoophilia is a recurring intense sexual arousal involving animals. It's a psychiatric condition. It's basically just simply defined as the sexual attraction to animals themselves, or non-human animals to be specific. Zoophiles are the people concerned with animals' health, safety, and sexual pleasure themselves. So they're not only concerned with their sexual pleasure, but also the animal's sexual pleasure. And then bestialists is the legal term for any sexual act between a non-human animal and a person. The bestialists themselves are people who only care about their own sexual pleasure and they don't care about the animal. So it's more along the lines of a form of abuse, if anything else. And then there are a few issues. Well, technically a lot, because there's no clear definition about the actual, like the sexual act performed on whether it's illegal or disorder or like the animal involved. But our textbook simply states that it's any sexual act with an animal or being sexually aroused by the animal themselves. Some history about zoophilia is that it started in the prehistoric times. And it began in the fourth glacial age, at least that's the earliest evidence we have of zoophilia itself. It can be found in cave paintings, carvings, and drawings on walls. And to be quite specific about the fourth glacial age, that was about 40,000 and 25,000 years ago. Ancient Egypt is also known for zoophilia. They have hieroglyphs depicting it. The men usually had sexual relations with cattle and other large domestic animals, and women were usually dogs. They also mastered having sex with crocodiles. So basically, they would just flip the crocodile on its back to the point where it couldn't flip itself over or fight back, and then the men would penetrate the crocodile. And this was thought to bring prosperity and then restore the potency of men. Now, on to ancient Greece and Rome. It was a very, very popular fetish. The bull itself was a symbol of fertility, so a lot of men had sex with bulls, and even the women did, because it's shown in literature that Zeus would often take the form of a bull to seduce women. And zoophilia, or sex with animals, was an open practice. It was also used as a sort of punishment in the Colosseum because they would use animals to sodomize the gladiators, or vice versa. They would sodomize the animals. And then in the Middle Ages, so intercourse with animals was seen as healthy for a little while. It was said to cure certain diseases, but they weren't very specific about what diseases it cured. And it later was associated with black magic and witchcraft because with Christianity, sex with an animal often meant that you were having sex with a demon because demons often, quote, often took the form of demons and was also related back to demonic possession, according to the church. Now, in modern times, it's still practiced, and there's multiple reasons, but no root cause of it yet. Most people report doing the act because they had a desire for sexual pleasure and affections, and they didn't get it from human contact. They also had a lack of interest in human sex and preferred animals over humans. They didn't believe they were attractive enough to find a human partner or popular enough to find a human partner. And I have another cause towards the end because I thought it explained why it occurs so often, but it's not really reported. So the demographics, like the people that are associated with dysphilia, are usually white males ages 16 to 78. They're report having good jobs and they have intimate human relationships. There's also sex offenders that participate in dysphilia because they start with animals and they slowly upgrade to humans, and it's a normal pattern that psychologists have noticed. There's also people who work closely with farm animals, such as animal husbandry, that participate in this philia. The most frequently abused animals are dogs, cats, and farm animals. So let's talk about how common it is. As a kink, it's quite common because if you look it up on Google and just search it and then just type up Zoophilia or Bestiality, I promise you there will be 100 different links to different porn videos. But overall, very few people report it. Our book goes into a little bit of detail about how it may be caused by operant conditioning. So basically, the person gets curious, they find out the act is pleasurable, and then they continue doing the act itself. And it appears to start at a young age, and it's usually due to prior child abuse and exposure to animal cruelty. So, like I said before, it starts with the animal, and then they slowly move up to mistreating humans. So here are references. Two of them are articles. One of them is an actual book with, I think, multiple articles in it. And then the other one is our textbook. Thank you guys for watching. You have a great day.